this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala, where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today's topic, we are going to talk about the odontogenic tumor. So without further ado, let's get started. Welcome back to another 10 in 10 series, where we cover each topic under 10 heading in 10 minutes. And today's topic is the ameloblastoma. Now, this is a true neoplasm of the enamel organ tissue, wherein there is no enamel formation happening. So, this is a process, this is a neoplasm of enamel organ, wherein there is no enamel formation. So, before that point, there is a differentiation and this leads to the tumor formation. So this is a neoplasm of the enamel organ type tissue. So basically the ameloblast, hence the name ameloblastoma. As we know that ameloblasts are the cells which forms the enamel. So there is going to be differentiation of ameloblast, proliferation of ameloblast to form a tumor, true tumor, true neoplasm. This is the most common neoplasm. So this is the ameloblastoma. So, Robinson described this tumor as unicentric, non-functional, intermittent growth. Now, see what happens. Before initially, it was called as edementinoma. So, this was given by Malices in 1885. But since there is no heart tissue which is formed, right? There is no enamel which is forming. So, the term is replaced to ameloblastoma by Churchill in 1934. Now, the origin is from the, of course, ameloblast originate from what? Originate from the dental organ. So these ameloblastoma, the tumor cells of ameloblastoma, they are arising from cell rest of dental organ, either the remnant of dental lamina or the remnant of Hertwig epithelial root sheath. So either they are the cell rest of dental there are remnants of the dental lamina or they are remnants of the Hertwig epithelial root sheath. So this is how these ameloblastic cells are proliferating in n numbers, giving rise to the neoplasm, which is the ameloblastoma. So how are we going to classify it? See, there are many classification based on the clinical type. As you can see, we have made multilocular radiolucency. So, all this is the multilocular type. Then we have the unicystic type, wherein there is going to be single cystic sac in the intraosseous. Then the third one we have is the peripheral or extraosseous, which is outside the bone, which occurs only 1%. So, most of the lesions, 80% of the lesion approximately, more than 80 I must say, are the conventional solid or the multicystic type, wherein we will see the multicystic spaces. And in that also we have the histological variants. The histological variants, these are the follicular pattern, the plexiform pattern, acanthomatous, granular, or we have the desmoplastic type. So all these types are the variants. We can write in histological types that these are the desmoplastic, plexiform, follicular, acanthomatous, granular. And clinically we have the multilocular, unicystic, or the peripheral. Third one is the peripheral, or the other can be malignant ameloblastoma or ameloblastic carcinoma. So, talking about ameloblastoma, multicystic type, right? Conventional solid or multicystic intraosseous. That means within the bone, this ameloblastoma. So, ameloblastoma as such is the most common odontogenic neoplasm of the oral cavity, and it is benign, locally aggressive lesion arising from the odontogenic epithelium, which we have covered. Now, it involves the second, third, fourth and fifth decay of life, and most common are affected are the males, mandibular region and the molar and ramus region. See, always remember this, that the mandible occurrence of ameloblastoma is more, and specifically the molar ramus region. So, if you take close to the angle of the mandible, so molar ramus region is most commonly affected. molar angle ramus area 3 times more affected than the premolar or the anterior region. So mandible M, remember M molar, M mandible, and M is males, are more affected. Now racial, black people are more affected with the ameloblastoma compared to others. So this is a slow growing, painless, bony, hard swelling, because ameloblast, it is definitely going to be the hard swelling, and patient will have facial asymmetry because of this large swelling. These large lesion can even displace the teeth, there can be pain paresthesia, teeth can be mobile, the involved teeth can be mobile, it can be locally invasive, and there can be infiltration of intermedullary spaces causing the erosion of the cortical bone. So if we see radiographically, we see two appearances, soap bubble or honeycomb appearance. As you can see, these big bubbles are the soap bubbles. So in case when the lesion is large, when the radiolucent loculations are large, then the appearance looks something like the soap bubble. When this multilocular radiolucent lesions or the loculations are small, then they appears like the comb, honeycomb appearance. So they look like the honeycomb. So that is why the honeycomb appearance. And these appearances, they have in between, they have this septa, which radio, in which this masses are there. So in between, if you see in between, there are these septa which are present. So radio lucency is there, radiolucent tumor mass is there, and also there is buccal and lingual cortical expansion, there is resorption of the root adjacent to the adjacent teeth, the margins of the lesion are irregular and scalloping. These large lesion will cause the expansion, distortion, destruction of the cortical plates. So there will be thin, very thin cortical plates. So if you see outside this mass, there is going to be very thin cortical plate which is left because the lesion is expanding. So expansion of the bony cortex occurs, and because the tumor grows from time and with time, and therefore only thin shelf of bone is left, which is ahead of the bone. As you can see, when it grows, so there is only thin bone which is left. So if we do the palpation, if we put the digital pressure, then this thin shell of the bone, it cracks. On digital palpation, we call it the egg shell crackling. So this is because of very thin shell of bone which is left, and when we palpate it, when we put the digital pressure, then this thin bone cracks on putting the digital pressure. So this, the sound which appears is the eggshell crackling sound. So that is why eggshell crackling. Also we can see the pathologic fractures, the tooth involved is vital. So all these things, even if suppose in desmoplichen desmoplastic type, this desmoplastic ameloblastoma is seen in the maxilla. So also it can be seen in the maxilla also. Sometimes when the lesion is too big, then it can invade into the ethmoidal air sinus. It can even go up to the cranial base. So all these variants are there in the ameloblastoma. Then we have the desmoplastic type, which is seen in the maxillary. So if we look at histological section, we have histological variations. So histological types are the granular, desmoplastic, follicular, acanthomatous, plexiform. So all these types. But what is the common feature in all of these histological types is that there is reverse polarization. So away from the basement membrane, as you can see, this is the basement membrane, and the nucleus is away from the basement membrane. So this is the common feature. We can see the hyperchromatism of the basal cell nuclei, as well as the palisading of these basal cell with the polarization of nucleus away from the basement membrane. We call it the reverse polarity. So reverse polarity is seen in all of the variations. So also there is cytoplasmic vacuolization of the basal cell. As you can see, there is a vacuole towards the basement membrane. So we have many patterns, like follicular pattern. If you can see in the follicular pattern, what happens? There is a cystic degeneration. So in between these, there are these peripheral cells which have the reverse polarization. As you can see, this is away from the basement membrane, right? And in between, there is a central mass of cells. Now these cells are more like a stellate reticulum cells, star-shaped cells. And there is a connective tissue matrix, and there is a cystic regeneration. So what do we see in the follicular pattern? That the pattern is more like a follicular. these odontogenic epithelial cells, they are in form of multiple follicles or islands, right? And there is reverse polarization of these basal epithelial cells. We can see these tall columnar cells or ameloblast-like cell, I can say. And there is a central mass of cells in between, which is a star in shape. Then we have the plexiform pattern. So, as you can see in the plexiform pattern, the epithelial cells, they proliferate, they anastomose with each other in a fish-like pattern. So, as you can see, fish net. Like a net of the fish. So these are overlapping each other like this. So there is a fish net appearance we see in case of a plexiform pattern. So in the plexiform pattern, these neoplastic odontogenic cells, they proliferate in form of a long continuous strands cords. So there are strands, anastomosing strands, which are, these strands are anastomosing with each other. As you can see, they are overlapping each other. And there is stellate reticular like cells in between. And if you look at the peripheral cells or the basal cells, these are cuboidal to columnar in shape. Now, the another variant we have is the acanthomatous type. As you can see in the acanthomatous type, in between we have the squamous metaplasia, which is taking place in the acanthomatous pattern. If you look at the granular pattern, now you see that there are granular cells, cuboidal or rounded cells, which are present. So these resemble like the granules. So lysosomes like structures. So these are the granular pattern, cell pattern, because these are placed in a granular like manner. Then we have the desmoplastic type. As you can see in the desmoplastic type, we have a lot of the densely fibrous stroma. As you can see, green color stroma is more compared to the other. So desmoplastic type, we have the very dense fibrous stroma, and there are also central cells which are present, right? And also there are thin cords of epithelial cells. As you can see, there are thin cords of epithelial cells which are present in the desmoplastic like pattern. So this is about the multilocular or variant. Right. So how are we going to treat it? We can treat it via the simple enucleation, or we can do the curettage to the end block resection to complete. We can remove it because reoccurrence rate is high. 50-90% reoccurrence rate is there. Also, we have another variants like unicystic ameloblastoma, wherein usually there is only one cystic sac. So in that also we have histological variants. We have luminal. So if you look at luminal is, when in the lumen space, there is neoplastic cells growth which is happening. Then we have the intraluminal. So intraluminal, if you see, they will be like this. From the lumen, they are coming. And then we have the mural type. So mural type will be present in between here. So like this, we have the unicystic variations, histological variations. Then we have the peripheral or extra osseous ameloblastoma. Now, this ameloblastoma is usually present in the gingival surface, posterior gingival and alveolar mucosa, commonly in the mandibular compared to the maxillary. Again, this is also painless, non-ulcerated. We will see the swelling in the middle-aged person. And then we have the malignant ameloblastoma or ameloblastic carcinoma. Now, malignant ameloblastoma is a tumor that shows histopathological features of ameloblastoma only, both in the primary tumor as well as it shows the same features in the metastatic deposition. Ameloblastic carcinoma is again an ameloblastoma that has cytological variations of malignancy in the primary tumor and in a reoccurrence or in a metastatic deposit. So this is about the ameloblastoma. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. So if you have enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Also, you can comment in the comment section below. And there is a link in the description box below to support me on Patreon as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. And the reference of this is the Shafers 8th edition as well as the Niveill 3rd edition. So guys, till then, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated. I will see you soon in the next video.